Okay, as you guys can now see, I have powered on my helicopter and plugged in all the servos. So now we are going to jump right into setup F to set the tail rotor limits. But before doing that, we have to make sure that the tail servo is 90 degrees, and also we have to make sure that the rudder is moving in the right direction and the servos and the gyro is also sensing in the right direction. So to make sure that the rudder is traveling in the right direction, when we move the rudder stick to the right, the upper blade has to move to the right, and when we move to the left, the upper blade has to move to the left. In case this is not happening, you go into your transmitter servo reverse function and reverse the rudder servo. The same way, right now we are going to check whether the gyro sensing is correct for the tail gyro. So to do this, I'm going to flick my tail to the right, and as you see, the blade is moving to the right and coming back to normal. In case your blade is moving to the left while flicking the tail right, that means your gyro is not sensing in the correct direction and you have to reverse this from the gyro. So as you can see, I do not need to change my rudder servo settings or my tail gyro settings. So we're going to head up into setup F first and set the tail rotor limits. Okay, so now I'm going to go into programming mode. It's gone steady A. Okay, now we're going to jump straight to F. Okay, now we are in setup F, and here we have to set the tail rotor limits. What you need to do is move the rudder stick so as the slider moves to one extreme, and leave it over there without any binding for few seconds. The status LED on the gyro will flash, and then you can move the tail stick to the other direction and set that limit. As you can see right now, I've moved my rudder stick to the position that I want, the maximum throw, and I've kept it for a few seconds, and the status LED has flashed and gone steady red. Now I'm going to move it in the other direction till I get no binding. As you can see, I have set the status LED has flashed purple and then gone steady. So now, as you can see, the parameter F or the setup F is now set up. That is the tail rotor limits. We are going to save this and go into the menu G right now. Now we are in menu G. This is the tail sensor direction. As you see, before going into setup, we had already checked if the gyro was sensing in the right direction or no. If your gyro was not sensing in the right direction, you simply move the rudder stick to the left or to the right to change it from normal to reverse. As you can see, my gyro sensing is normal, so it displays the status LED red. In case you have to reverse it, you just move your rudder stick and the status LED would go to blue. There you go, it's gone to blue. That means right now your gyro sensing is reversed. But as you have seen earlier, I do not require my gyro sensing to be reversed, so I'm going to set it back to normal. Okay, as you see, I've set it back to normal. The status LED has gone red. Now guys, running this gyro only as a tail gyro, you guys have your setup complete. These are all the steps required for setting up this gyro as a tail gyro. For guys running a flybarless gyro, this gyro as a flybarless gyro, we have a few more steps ahead to set up this wash plate and stuff. So we'll get there.